Hey, what's up guys? Dopesonar930 here. Hopefully you guys can hear me alright. This is going to be a really quick video. I'm just going to read you guys something and then link you over to it in case you want to read more on it. Something really, really cool was released, and this is, to me, this is like one of the biggest things that's come out in the modding scene for Xboxes in a while now. And so I'm just going to read to you what was posted yesterday, March 2nd of 2013. I just saw this today. It says, a few months ago, we brought you DGX, the Double Glitch X, which enables the key retrieval from all slim consoles above dashboard version 15.5.7.2. The DGX was the first and only hackable to do this and worked with great success, enabling the scene to continue on with its homebrew endeavors. For some bizarre reason, some outsiders are claiming that DGX was not good enough and that it was too slow. The fact that there was nothing else that could achieve the hack, and the fact that there are hundreds and hundreds of pro modders posting their success stories with boot times between 5 and 30 seconds, tell otherwise. I guess that completely went over their heads. In the last week, a leaked bootloader has been passed around by sources who wish to remain anonymous, which allows booting without knowing the CPU key, enabling our DGX method to work with a single glitch. To use, simply flash the 360 using any reset glitch hack board. Naturally, you will get the very best result on the CR3 Pro or even a converted DGX. So this now opens two doors. One, compile a solid set of ECCs for standard reset glitch hack boards that can recover keys on fat models, and Trinity and Corona. The speed and performance will be nowhere near as good as the DGX, but it will still work all the same. Much like the DGX, key recovery is a one-time process anyway. So what that's saying is it'll allow you to convert or to use your actual CoolRunner reset glitch hack boards and use them as if it was a DGX to get your CPU key. So that's really cool. And the new hack also, it says to design a new hack for the DGX hardware so that now it can be converted to what we will call RGX, which is called Regular Glitch X. As the DGX hardware has similar parts used by the high-performance CR3 Pro, the DGX can be used as a regular RGH board, but much faster and better performance than any other 64-based boards. In fact, the only board that will be better is the CR3 Pro. Everything else, it will just smoke. What that means, guys, is that you can use your DGX and use it to get the CPU key, then you can flash these new files to it, and it's actually going to turn it into a glitch chip. So you can use it as a permanent chip, and you don't have to desolder and resolder it, and it's really, really good. I actually just did this right now. I'm making a tutorial on it. If you guys are interested, I'll post a link in the description. And my boot times right now, after I tweaked it after the video, I'm getting it to boot in like 2 to 3 glitches every single time, and that's with minimal tweaking. So I'll link you guys over to Team Executor's forums and this little news thing if you want to read more, and the download links are there too for all the files you're going to need. So I'm really excited, guys. This is big news, and hopefully you guys are excited too. Anyways, I apologize for the crappy quality, but hopefully, you know, the goal was just get the news out there to you guys, and that's that. So anyways, guys, Dopesonar930, thanks for watching, and if you liked the video, please thumbs up and subscribe for more. Peace.